In case you haven't heard, there is a Golem game that's going to be coming in 2021 for the next generation of consoles and PC. Lord of the Rings Golem is what it is currently called, and it is supposed to launch in 2021. And I am so freaking excited about this game. Everything that I've been hearing about this game up to this point, it has been sounding really, really interesting to me. It sounds like it's going to be an action type of game, but you get to kind of choose your own path. And as you do, you will start to become more Smeagol-ish or Gollum-ish. So I'm very, very excited about what this game could be. There's a lot of potential for what this game could be, and it sounds great. So let's go ahead and take a look at what we have here, see if there's any more information about the game. And let's see what we got. So new details for Lord of the Rings Golem have been revealed along with the game's platforms and launch date. Announced back in March 2019, we have not heard much from the game since then, including what systems the game would be coming out to, outside of Windows PC. During an interview in Edge Magazine's February 2020 issue, Daedalic Entertainment confirmed the game will be coming to the PlayStation 5 and Xbox Series X. More details were also revealed during the interview. For example, the studio seeks to have their own version of Gollum, as explained by art director Matthias Fischer. Tolkien didn't give a size reference for Gollum to begin with, so in the first illustrations, he's gigantic. He's like a monster emerging from the swamp. Whether this will be the studio's inspiration or something else was not revealed. So that's kind of interesting. It isn't going to be based off of like the movie version of Gollum. It's going to be their own take on the character, which will be cool. I'm excited about that, actually. Though senior producer Kai Fiebig, I hope I pronounced that right, reiterated that it would not be inspired by the movies, adding they do not want to displease the folks who have already seen the movies, but in short, he doesn't look like Andy Serkis. We started with the person he was and then evolved him. You can now see that he was once something like a human being before the ring corrupted him. So that's cool. You know, I'm fine with that. I'm fine with that. There, you know, at the end of the day, as long as it is still based off of more so the books and stuff, then I am totally fine with that. I love the Lord of the Rings movies. They're my favorite movies of all time, and nothing else even comes close to touching Lord of the Rings for me. But I am excited to see someone else kind of their take on what Lord of the Rings could be and their character and the characters that are in Lord of the Rings. And it sounds like that's kind of what they're going to be doing with Gollum. So I'm fine with that. I'm actually fine with that. Some narrative elements were revealed, however, in IGN's words, you play as Gollum as he's deep into his corruption by the One Ring. Despite this, he can convey emotions not seen in the films, letting him be more sympathetic and relatable, something that is important as you'll be spending 20 or so hours with him. Fiebig explained further, we have more storytelling possibilities than the movies ever had, and for us, it was very important to show a different set of emotions. We need somebody you could almost love, and on the other hand, somebody you can really be afraid of. And at some points, trust me, you will fear him. That sounds awesome. Games Radar covered a tiny piece of the story in some depth. Gollum begins in a Mordor fortress called Barad-dûr, where Gollum is imprisoned. After this, the person will see more of Middle-earth, with their interview promising giant, persistent environments, each harboring several quest lines and a range of friendly or unfriendly faces. Other returning characters that will distance themselves from the films are the Nazgûl. Ooh. Intriguing. Fischer explained with surprising belittlement, they were an interesting challenge because it's so well documented that where they were in the wider narrative. It was like, can we use the cool Nazgûl? I think ours are the less cool ones. They're the drummer and brass player of the band, but we have a chance to make them more popular. That's cool. You know, let me just say this right now. Maybe I'm biased, but it's going to be really hard for them to come up with anything that's cooler than what the movies came up with. I'm a little biased, but that's how I feel about it. The Nazgûl were perfect. Gollum was perfect. Everything about those movies are perfect. Yeah, as you can see, the fanboy of me for Lord of the Rings is starting to come out a little bit. But I am excited. I do want to see someone else's kind of vision about what Middle-earth could be, and I think I'm actually more excited for this game now because of that. Gameplay was also discussed, along with stealth, large levels, and in IGN's words, a move away from the violence that dominates other Lord of the Rings games. Gollum's Fractured Mind is also a gameplay feature, so it sounds like it could be a lot more of like a stealth type of game, I don't know, maybe something like Styx, but hopefully better than Styx is kind of what it sounds like to me. Along with several choice-based moments, game designer Martin Wilkes explains further, it's not just choosing to be Smeagol or Gollum, because for Gollum, as an entity, it's not that easy. Each personality is being attacked by the other. Each has to defend himself. You will have maybe two, three, or four conflicts per chapter that lead to a final decision point. And at this final decision point, it will be harder to pick Smeagol, for example, if you've always fought for the Gollum side before. That is so freaking cool. I love everything that I'm hearing about this game so far. This will not be the last Lord of the Rings game we see from Datalic Entertainment. CEO Carsten Fischelman confirmed the company has a long-running contract and will create several games in the setting. I'm so excited. Fischelman explained that it means maybe the next game is obviously not Gollum 2. That doesn't make sense. It could be some other character, but it will be comparable to what we're now trying with Gollum. That is so cool. I am so excited for this game. I've been wanting to get another Middle-earth game for a really long time now. Well, I guess we did get Shadow of Mord or Shadow of War a couple of years ago, but besides that, I am really excited to see what we're gonna be getting with this. Also, Amazon is actually making a Lord of the Rings MMO as well that's going to be on the PS5 and Xbox Series X and PC as well, I believe. So that'll be interesting, and I'll definitely do some more research about that and bring you guys a video about that as well. Very excited. I am happy that we're getting more Middle Earth type of stuff. I don't think anything that will be created will be able to top the original trilogy. That's funny, original trilogy, the Lord of the Rings trilogy from Peter Jackson. But as long as they don't go the direction of Lucasfilm and don't kind of try to take some sort of soy woke type of route with Lord of the Rings, and they try to still honor Tolkien and his vision and his legacy, they will do just fine with whatever they put out there. That's Lord of the Rings, Middle Earth, whatever. They just need to continue to do that. Don't be tempted by the woke nonsense that's going on out there. Just give us good games, good movies, good shows with stories, great characters, and all of it honoring to the legacy and vision of Tolkien. You will do just fine. So with that being said, let me know in the comments below what you think about this. What do you think about this Gollum game? Does it sound interesting to you? Hope you guys enjoyed, and I will talk to you all very soon in another video. Talk to you later. Bye.
Hey, this is Jay with Geeks and Gamers with a special announcement. Over the past few years, several of us have been trying to complete a home that will house orphans and displaced children in the country of El Salvador. We were hoping that this home would be finished by the time Christmas rolled around in 2019. Unfortunately, we did not meet our goal to complete this home. Partnering with Jeremy and all of us here at Geeks and Gamers, and with you, we are setting up a GoFundMe to raise some funds that hopefully will help us get closer to our goal in completing this home. We will use the money to hire professionals to check out the home and also pay for some educational costs for many of the children. This will help with the burden of those raising money, and more money can be put into this home to be completed. Me and several staff members from Geeks and Gamers will be traveling to El Salvador at the end of May, that we can bring a significant amount of money to finish this project. We hope that you would want to partner with us in this as well. So please click on the link, read about it, and do the best that you can. Thank you so much.